Here are 5 setting tips for you as a setter. The first one is, there's no such thing as a bad pass. There's just different ways to get there, different footwork that you've learned to get there and move to the ball. You know, a lot of times I've had passers come up to me and say, oh, Keely, my bad on that pass. And I look back at them and I'm like, oh, I like didn't even notice. I was like, keep working hard. But that's the idea you want to create, that they don't have to be perfect because you're not perfect as a setter. A lot of times your hitter makes up for your bad sets, but together we're going to work hard. So that's a huge, you can't be a setter that makes excuses all the time. There's no such thing as a bad pass, just different footwork to get there. Number 2, you need to learn the different personalities of your teammates so you know how to communicate with them. Some teammates need quiet, calm, one-on-one, face-to-face time to say something really there. And some teammates need in-your-face, cheering, chest bumping, like type of energy. You need to know which type of teammate that you're dealing with and how they need to be motivated. Number 3, be coachable. A simple way to do this is with eye contact and a head nod when your coach is talking. That shows that you're listening, that you understand what they're saying, and you will go ahead and try. If you have questions, you have questions, great. But you can't be that player in the timeouts or the huddles, looking down, looking around. Be the one that makes eye contact with your coach and do what they ask you to do. Number 4, it's important to communicate strategy. So if your idea is to set a ball with the shortest blocker, maybe on the outside, you tell your middle, hey, try to run this play, yell it really loud, and I'm going to set outside. So this way that the middle blocker knows that they have a role that they're trying to get that point accomplished. So this is how you create nice strong unity on your team by communicating strategy, what you want to do. Even sometimes what happens when the passer, you want to tip the ball like to that deep corner 5, so you tell your passers, hey, pass me a ball flat so I can take it because it's wide open. When you communicate strategy and let's say it works, this is when teammates get excited and then you stay focused to keep attacking the other team as one unit. And number 5, so for those hitters that really don't get set that often, if you want them to feel successful at a time that you want to set them, let them know you're going to set them. A lot of times when hitters don't get set often, they're not expecting the ball, and then all of a sudden the ball comes and they're like a little frantic because they don't expect the ball. But when you know in your head that you want to get them the ball for a strategy reason, or maybe you're up by a lot and now can give them a ball, go ahead and tell them, hey Susie, I'm gonna set you this ball. So she knows, she's expecting it, and then gives her a better chance to be successful. Okay, so it's done?
Yeah.
Okay, peace.